Struggling with your finances?
Struggling at work?
With your social life?
Or with your spiritual life?
We invite you to join us
on our family table talk every Saturday
at 7:30 a.m. on my TV.
Or catch us on our Facebook page. Bulabinaka, greetings this wonderful morning, Saturday, 7:30. Normally we are speaking on family table talk. It's an honor, it's a privilege, humbling experience to serve you this morning. Those of you that are listening from our villages, eh? We can take the barbu to many we call a biti, scaru sama bullet to any matakanisi and dai, malo bula, bula re, bula sia, dolabina, arneandra. Ikan dengan dati ko na nonda bono alam niyo viti na matagal ni si kanindai sa matiko mai na my television and screen level sa na wallet si platform sa na Facebook sa kero mga bula tugani mga yano tugani na matagal ni si kanindai bula minaga bikin na nguni bulit o doko o klasa may tiga buna noa nonda serikil level mga embaki mga bula tugani pinawali mo na gravitabi may zabon doon embaki and sa may siwitatali and Runa Undolu. Wagan total, wagan bulat tu ani matangani sini dai, tak tu mengani kata lau si sebagai anak tu kena mode, si nanda potonga si tu tubi tonga, wara kata kami de, wagan anak tiko, ini ku saya anak tu tu, ku sange big screen, sinu. Bina boleh bina orang besar satu.
Greetings to those of you that are thank you so much for believing this. But we can better or improve our. All of you out there in the villages and in the Fiji Islands and also outside Fiji. For those of you we get to meet saying that you're all to those of you in New Zealand, in just taking the time to out of the number in our viewership, and we would like to say today thank you so much. And also in Australia, as and when we do come meeting up at the shopping mall and also in the eatery place, thank you as well. We may not have, we would like to see in Canada, all the way in Manitoba, and also to a big, vast area of the States of America. Yeah. We met people all the way from Sacramento to San Rafael to Santa Rosa, and also to the Bay at this time to say in Bulabinaka. And thank you for tuning in and family. And I know you're tuning in also this morning. When you love your mom, gonna beautiful children. Thank you. Programs, and not only that, it didn't stop there, but also support and sponsor. most of our people and most of the zones here in Fiji, especially in Kandavu, we would like to make a mention and say thank you so much for your support. To the family that always follow from Saturday Island, we have over England. Thank Perisia came and introduced herself, and I'm trying to think, okay, where have I met her before? And the way she was talking to me, it's like she's met me before, and I'm trying to figure out, you know, did I miss anything? And right towards the end of our conversation, that I'm back to England on the week. And from Europe, we may not have the opportunity like to the family table talk, to the little advices, little counsel, or little discussion that is we have. Like what we always say, we are not perfect. It's not that we're having this program telling everybody that we are the perfect family. No, we are not. We have shortfalls just like you, and better than yours. About ours, then it gives. Your church or do not have those kind of that with you they can talk.
Yeah, we will take this time to welcome tonight's we take this time to say Bulaminaka all the way from Turek in Suva. Not forgetting all the rugby boys that you are there in Europe. Time to say Bulaminaka.
Yeah, thank you.
And the only is through some program like this on Family Table Talk all the way from Fiji. So greetings from Fiji. Morning here in Suva. There's a cyclone just originate near Solomon Island, and it's moving moving to Australia. That means moving westward at the moment, and we are hoping to have a wonderful at the end of the year. And those of you that are preparing to go and celebrate, Renlongan of Fiber sa Wakambulan Tugani and Matakani Singan Dendai. And Nontanguna Binakongo, eh?
Well, we have been talking towards the end of the year. There is always money that we always receive towards the year. Previous, it comes along the way that you never and you know, put out another reminder to us. Write down your list. When you do write your list, you will be guided by what you have written and be reminded by what you've written. If you don't write down anything, then your money you are just using the money anyhow because it's no guideline. But when you write it down, then you will see, say, like, if you and if you don't add that $200 too, then the $200 will come and evaporate in the air like you never received it, like you never had it. But if you write it down and you say, okay, I'm going to clear this, I'm going to do this, So find the time this week, or find the time this weekend, or next week. Write down the realities of your finances. What are your current? What are your pending? If you still have your rent that needs to be cleared, or you still owe money to some people that you need to pay, and whatever that you're owing, write it down. Because when you don't write it down, then you don't know the total of money that you owe, and you're always thinking that you don't owe as much. But when you write it down and you total it, then you realize, boy, this is the kind of money that I need to save or to pay back. Only when you write it down and you see the total, then you are convicted that it's quite a fair bit of money, which means whatever comes is not available and free for you to use anyhow, but to be channeled to all these areas. So write down. Se na vida cai tudo do nosso soma na vale meca na rende se me resume na vula saote gosta vula talo ti semba na wine na livro livro é só na bili que da sangue de rawni em robaka and there are some bills that you cannot run away from it. It's like it will follow you. Yeah. Whether you hide or you jump or you whatever it should do, it will follow you. That bills will follow you. You can't get rid of it. And that's a shelter, you know, the basic needs, the necessities of life. And your water bills, your electricity bills for those of you in the urban areas. And those are the bills that follow you. So write it down. If you owe them, then you write it down. So when you list them down, like your pending and what is projected for December, Don't rule out December. Write down December. Remember, all other months you have your money coming in and it goes straight to where it's supposed to go. December is quite different because you have your family, you have your friends. It's a festive season. Whether you like it or not, it's there. You cannot change that. And your money in December, it's very challenging because the same money you've been receiving every month, you've been religiously just paying what needs to be paid and buying what needs to be bought. But when it comes to December, it's a bit of a disarray, which means you may not have the full control of your finances and your priority may change. Your rent and your water and your electricity used to be a priority normal for the last few months. But when it comes to December, it no longer becomes a priority because you prioritize your family gathering, you prioritize, I mean, it still has its importance. But at the end of the day, you are the only person that will be contributing here and also contributing here. If you contribute less here, well, maybe they will say, oh, kwe living na living na none of us, that's the only donor kai bulia. Living na none of us, that's the only donor kai kotamai. Oh, they know that person. Always talk too much, but never contribute as much. Well, that's a flag. You cop when you do that. But for your rent and all these things, no one is going to help you here.
No.
This is the only, I mean, you are accountable for your family, for their shelter, and also for their basic needs. And so those are the things that you need to, you know, prioritize and value, which is very important for you to write down. So after you write all these things down, then you project. Don't wait for the money to come in. You project, meaning if I'm getting my pay, how much? What is my actual pay? If I'm getting weekly, what is my actual? If I'm getting fortnightly, what is my actual pay? If I'm getting monthly, what is my, you know, the amount that I get? So project the money that you're getting and have this list that are already written and plan on how that money comes in and what is the importance, which means you've written what you're owing, which is your arrears or pending. You've written what you need that is projected for the month of December. And on top of these basic things that you cannot run away from, then you have your family, your children that are supposedly going back to school next year. On which level? On which year? What is required of them? I know, you know, the Ministry of Education, and we must thank the Minister of Education, you know, just ruling out no levies. No, as much as possible, the government is helping us to try and send all our children to school. And not only that, it becomes a big help to your, you know, to your budget because you know, okay, you know, they're good. And it feels good because not as much of the money that we used to put aside for children going back to school. Now it's not as much because the government assistance is very good here in Fiji, I'm talking about. Well, with that said, then you need to note down all those things. So when your money that you're, the money that you project coming in, it's like your budgeting, eh? You're planning your budget. The money that come in, then you'll see. What nada vane lava mbula kwa la kuma ne lava kwa kuna visa mi kene dene kusi mbere torra e kusa na maka ni kuna torra kuku visa mi babi madawa wa madawa rua se vaka gula e kusa kila ne lava kuma ise ke kuna dobo limolita ke if you are selling items, if you have a market stall, or if you're in the flea market, or if you have a small business, what kind of money you know you can project that is coming your way. And those are the money that you can have as the fundamental basis, which means don't overthink it for you to think, okay, that can happen, that can happen. You will know when your business boosts, you know when you drive. Because if you have a business, you can control the money that come to you, then after writing down all that, then it becomes a motive in your heart to say, well, this is the amount that I owe and the amount that I need to pay that are in arrears, and this is what I need to have in December. And also, write down the budget of your family gathering. Que vai cair com ele sem estudo na corra, nada vai na metade. Que vai cair que mandou sem estudo para matar o vale, nada vai na metade. Que vai cair que mandou na lá com inácio se varra, nada vai e nada vai na cost e na vacabuna. Or what other costs are you going to incur? Which means maybe in the rental car, maybe the fuel for that rental car, or if you're going in the bus, what are the bus fares? So you can calculate que é que nós vamos dar o cautetico. Nós vamos dizer que ele tem que na coia, na ilha vai ter lá, ou ir com a bita volta, que na ilha vai ter que não dar bula de dezembro, que na ilha vai ter que não dar bula de dezembro, que na ilha vai ter que não dar bula de novembro, que na ilha vai ter que na ilha vai ter que não dar bula de novembro, que na ilha vai ter que não dar bula de novembro, que na ilha vai ter que não dar bula de novembro, que na ilha vai ter que na priority na não dar bula de clear, vale que vai ter corrente de que não dar clear, que vai ter que não dar bula de clear, demos no why, que vai ter que não dar bula de livro. Clear. So na di nao, iko nando do numa soma, me kakuo ni kaulebi na service ya nando mdo bale. So, clear taka na November, na December iko kila. Na ngone kongele wabwa kitu kikene na singi studio kule marotiko, iko sabavyengu, niko kila, that your bills for December is done. You know, wherever you go, and you know that money is not going to come in because it's a festive season, pay up your bills, so when you go, you know, you are ready to come back and start the month of January 2024 in another new year, because you know, you have closed 2023, even though you are still in 2023. Yeah. So those are the things that you need to, you know, itemize, write it down, and start thinking about it now. Don't wait until the money come in, I guarantee. You want to send anyone like you, like my love, and I love go revoke, and what on the now, we say, one ravi, you could be not to my, or December, December, and you kai so make it. One, a big cover come at a lie. So you know, even if you're left with $10 or $20, and you know you've cleared your debts, you've paid for the month of December, you have enough money to go buy for Christmas, and you have about $10 or $20, good enough. That's good enough. And for those of you who are Christians and believe in God, well, pray. With faith, that's going to work out. With that $10, it's amazing on how it can work out. So, for you to exercise wisdom in every step of the way, for you to think and think again, ask yourself whether this is correct, whether I can do this, whether this is the right way of doing it. You know, don't just out of the moment, spur of the moment for you to do things, because it's either you lose a substantial amount of money, or you go without being accountable or paying up the things that you can afford to clear, and then yet you miss the opportunity to do so.
Yeah, for those of us that we don't write, it's just like going to the shop. When you don't have a shopping list, you'll start to buy things that
you don't need.
You don't really need. And by the time you arrive home, you bought everything that you want and nothing that you need.
Yes.
And that's why it's very important for us to write down, as Randini is saying, that's just a budgeting. And most of the time, we are challenged with few things.
Yeah.
Number one, the atmosphere. The atmosphere or the environment that we are in. November, December, end of the year. So it will be a lot of gathering. Will be a lot of partying and get together. That we will be challenged. Whether we like it or not, it will be there. And that's why she's sharing, if you patch up everything, every credit and every things that are due for November and December, so you come, and even if you left with $10 or $20, I tell you that's okay.
Yeah, that's good enough.
That's good enough.
Because the commitment for this festive season, it's not only in your family, it's a workplace, even the church. There's a lot of things going. It's like breakup party here, Thanksgiving party here, all those things, you know, it one way or the other, it affects your wallet. There's money coming out of your wallet to make that happen.
Yeah. Number one, it's your environment.
Yeah.
See, we're sharing your environment that you cannot run away from it. It's the end of the festive season. Sometimes we plan as families to go to the village, and sometimes we plan for the church. A lot of things. Number two, the people that you mingle with, they can become your challenge. Because everybody want to flow in the normal flow, or the stemness, the festive flow, or the party flow, or the makasambu sambu flow. And a challenge taki kenda, na buno akenda siya matiko kina. Kime wale, ni ngauna ko budget taki kokina, and a limit taka na buno ko tiko kina. But ni yung sa budget wa tu, sa commit kenda tu na numu finance. So, and a rendre vehiko, se na rendre mo na lako siwita se ko, se kong basuka, e so na ka, ko sa tuwa na otitu. Kime wale, ndo na ka, vibu kime kenda, mo tuwa na rawa, kumbi taka rawa. Mena kako ni ko tatara talia sa nungo balta na ilabo, ilabo tiko nga eh. Tutu ya bibida mako si weekend na ito ke. Ni ngone tiko kina na ilabo and do mila mila tonga na lingan na menda lago na li tapa tapa toka and na misi niya nasa nilala nga eh. Ni tiko na ilabo. Kaya mabali, na numu totolo nga ni wasi wasea ka bakaw ta kina banua indo dun me bakaw kina me simata bonata kedi na kaya indo dun me bonati. And lako may na 2024 and ena tarabina kana no mumbula sena pagaru ta katuna no mumbula kena na no tumbula no ngani sena ngani buli ena be singa tale kataraba na January February do talengo do talmenda ka menda na ngaro ne sona e sona songo tumbu koso e sona sobo da sona songo tumbu koso e sona ngau na kena do toro sertu nga ba mamanda enda do kalo enikina lago enikina nanga ye kina la ni sale pagan ta kina e sona ila bo sona sona tiknika enda sawa se toka me so be kina li liba so be kina na rent we can se we can da sa so voli valitiko da so so mitiko ko tu na ti rendi ne sona ka endo ndonu nga on sino rin rotaka se ko lago ba langi se ko le lago nga ina koro se ko sanga ni da ka se ba da mutu na mu marotaka na mu ni mbakingo ye sona nambili endo ndonu nga mona soma se ba da ba se ba da ba endo ndonu nga mona soma bale ke ba kanda ro sini alo matu otaka ya na mai daba na 2023 sa teke butu na bimbi kini dol dola kina ka endo ndonu mo mo soso mikina lago mai na January endama
Yeah, that goes back to the beginning of the year. I've always emphasized the fact, like when you start the year, project the end of the year, which means when the year comes, don't live blindly like the end of the year is not going to come. It will come. As we spoke in January for the family table talk, I was emphasizing mostly on how you do your budget, on how you can start working planning from the beginning of the year. Now that we have come towards the end of the year. And I believe most of us didn't have the opportunity to really follow, you know, what we need to do. But, and yet when we come to December, then we felt, oh, I should have, could have. But, you know, you've gone past the year. And you shouldn't forget that, but take that with you for the upcoming year. And try, keep on trying until you achieve it. Keep on trying until you say to yourself, okay, I can master this. And because no one is perfect, it's all learning. And in the learning process, when you're willing to learn, then it takes you, makes you a better person. No one is perfect. As and when you're willing to learn, then it you know, it takes you to another level, takes you to another level. And you gain knowledge, you gain confidence, and you gain things that you never have as you go along the way. Yeah. So say if in the beginning of the year, which you may not have done it, but take it as a thought for 2024. If you're working and you have access to your account and you don't have any problems in creating a new accounts within your account, within the bank that you bank with, and I'm speaking to you also foreign, for those of you that are outside Fiji, you have the capability of opening other accounts within the same bank, or you have you know, a choice with other banks. Like in Fiji, we have HFC, we have BRED, we have Westpac, ANZ, and we have BSP. So we have about 5 banks to choose from. But for other countries, you have quite a fair bit of banks to choose from as well. So try and find out how do you open a new account. As and when you do, then you allocate an account for the end of the year. Or you allocate an account for your mortgage or you know, your investment, what you want to buy. If you're planning to buy a house, if you're planning to buy a car, or for you to bump up or build up your deposit for that particular loan that you cannot really get the substantial amount that you need to be able to get that loan. These are the accounts, because as soon as you get your pay, then you do deduction direct from source. Don't take it out and then you go and deposit. No, allow the bank deduction to do it. You program it. Like in Fiji, we have that, you know, that ability. Online, you can go online to all the banks and you can program your deduction, or you can program your transfers. As and when that date pops up, you cannot control it. Your account automatically does what it's supposed to be done because you've already programmed it. That will help you. Because when you get your pay, the money that you're receiving, you know this is the money that I need to pay for the rent or to pay for the house. Because if you're if you have a loan, your mortgage is already deducted straight from source or straight from your, you know, from your salary. But this little money, it can be $10 to this account, it can be $20 to this account. Every time you get paid, whether it's weekly, monthly, or fortnightly, whenever you get a pay, this $10 automatically go there. You don't have any control over it because you've programmed it. And that money, it adds up. It really does. And you tell yourself, that's the money that is there, but I don't access it. Which means if you, say, I'm speaking for Fiji. If you're in Fiji and you open a Westpac account, and it's a deduction from your ANZ account, then don't use that Westpac card. Don't even get yourself a card, or you cut your card and live without that card for the whole year. All you know, your money is going there. Your money is going there. Your deduction is going there. And you keep a record of it. Keep a tally in your bag, in your book, for you to know, okay, this money that I've saved is amount up to this. And if you're not a very good bookkeeper and you're not a very good saver, then don't keep a record, because you know once you see the money there, you will go and get it. So blindly, just leave it. And you just say to yourself, this is the only money that I have, which is the leftover money that comes. If you're a Christian, you organize your tithe to go wherever it goes. And all these savings, if you're paying your mortgage, then it's automatically deducted from your payroll. And whatever money that comes out, then that's the money for you to figure out. And then at home, I try and have a pocket. There is a plastic pocket that have, you know, dividers inside. You can get it from Suva Bookshop if you're in Suva and any other bookshop in Fiji. But for US, you can get it from the 99ers. I saw it in the Dollar Tree shop as well, or even at Walmart. And there in Europe, you have your, you know, bookshop out there that you can pick up all these pieces. And even the Poundland have got all those things. So the compartment go, you can label taka, rent, water, electricity, and food, and miscellaneous, other things. So when your pay come out, you will know. Like if there is a need for your rent to be paid, then this compartment, you must have an envelope. Now, lava kere ko kila ikombita na namo visomi, and every mother or seven mother or rua, towards your rent, put the cash inside that envelope. Put that money inside that envelope. So put the money in those envelopes. As and when it's due, you go to this compartment, you take it out, and you count all the dollars and say, okay, I only have a few more dollars to work. Because when you do that, your mind is organized, knowing this is what I lack. And apart from that, apart from your whatever that you do, on the side that I've explained, you need to have a book to write out. Like if you have a book and you have rent, you have water, write it down. Like what I said, I work for an organization. We have a payment voucher to justify the spend, which means it needs to be requested for, it needs to be verified, and needs to be approved. There's three signatories on that. Not only for the company, even for the church that I belong to, which I look after the administration, we have payment vouchers, which means every spend of money, whether it's $1 or right up to $100 or $1,000, it must be justified that you're making this spend. You know, it's verified because it's a spend that you cannot avoid. You need to. And out of these two payment vouchers, I create my own, and I call it personal payment voucher, which means as and when I spend money on my grandchildren, if anything that is happening in school, I will get those receipts, and I have a file, and I know people that work with me, they can be testament to what I'm sharing today. And in my office, I've got a file for my personal payment vouchers. I've got a book for my personal spend. I write down what I spend in my family, what I spend on other things. So I have a record of it. Even the savings that I put in my account, I have a book for it that talks about my account and the money that I put in, and also the money that I spend. And if I spend money coming out helping, maybe the company didn't, you know, there's some stakeholders, they don't take check, or they don't, you know, it takes a long process to be paid. So sometimes I use my card for that, not only for the company, but for the ministry as well. And as and when I do use that card, I'll get all the receipts done. I'll fill out the payment voucher from the ministry or the company to bring that money back and offset and put it back into my account. So when you take control of the money coming in, going out, regardless of how little it may be or how huge your money is, When your management is good, you can make up something greater from the little money that you can. You know, with the little money that you get, and then you say to yourself, oh, I won't be able to do that because it's too much. If I have to deduct my saving and deduct towards the function, towards the end of the year, and I will be left with nothing. Well, when you're left with the little that you have, and then you work yourself from there, and you look out, what are the little things that you can do? Even if you're working, can you make some pasta roti, or can you make some hot dogs? I've always shared this. When I was working, I was getting paid well, working in at the hangar, looking good, getting dressed, going to work every day for Air Pacific then. Now it's Fiji Airways. But yet, my containers of hot dogs, my roti curry and everything in my car, still getting my orders to the neighboring companies around there at the airport, TFL. I get it delivered. I get my money. I, you know, do something in my house, style my house, paint my house. So because I know the money that I get on my pay is not enough for me to be doing all these things that I project. So don't be guided or just be strict, you know, thinking that this is the only money you get. No, you look out. Oh no, it's amazing what you can achieve. So like what I mentioned earlier, if this is what you have done until the end of the year now, and you say to yourself, I should have, could have, don't go there. You need to look back, learn from it, and then you say to yourself,